Elite wine bottle. This is one of the large wine bottles. This is a small wine bottle. They have these lit corks, which are kind of cool because you turn them on and they're pull out. They're all attached to the little LED lights. I always paint the cork or glitter the cork. There's one. That's a big one. This is a smaller bottle, and this one has red writing on it, which I will not do anymore. It doesn't show up, but it's kind of pretty once it's lit up. You don't get the full effect with all these fluorescent lights. So the first thing that I do is I have printed out... Daisy, go away. My Boston Terriers are going to knock things over. I've printed out an oval right here. I use really cheap contact paper from Walmart, or this I think came from Fred Meyer's. And I don't have my glasses, so I can't see. There we go. So we're going to take that off. We're left with this. This one is bigger. It was a bigger pattern, but I designed something to go around it, so I made a smaller one first. So I'm going to show you how to do a small oval on a large bottle. So I just peeled that off. And what I do, if you can see, to get it on, is I do this with my, fold my decal or my oval like that. It seems to stick better if I do it this way. And then so what I do is get it even, put it right about where I want it to go, and stick it on like so. And for me, that is not even. So I'm going to take it off and try again. I'm sure there's lots of ways to make it even. I usually just eyeball everything. There we go. So it's going to go on like so. You'll get some wrinkles in it. For this particular one, we don't want wrinkles on the in the middle. It doesn't matter if there's wrinkles around the edge, but we want it to be the exact size because I've made vines that go around the outside. So once you have that on it, you can keep that on. This one didn't have the little wrinkles around the top here, but if you have them, you just kind of push them out a little bit and you're going to see the wrinkles, and that's okay. It doesn't matter. So then the next thing I want to do is I keep my glue in a little plastic container. I buy my glue. Let's see if we can get it. We can't. Buy the gallon at Home Depot. And that's my crackle medium. I do not spend a lot of money on crackle mediums from the store. So I'm going to see if I can get this in just a little bit better. There we go. So I've been using just a regular paintbrush, and so we're going to do this really fast. I'm going to go ahead and show you the whole process. I'm just kind of glooping it on there right now. I'll go back over it in a minute. This is a lifesaver. This is a Lazy Susan, and that's how I make all these crackle projects. It just is way easier, and that's how I do it. Anyway, so I start at the top, and then I go around, kind of even that out just a little bit. The more of the glue that you have on, the thicker the cracks are going to be. So if you want something that looks really thick, then you just put more on it. These particular bottles right there have a thickness of about what I'm doing right here. I have done the thicker ones. I'm not really crazy about it, so I don't do it much. And then I'm just going to go all the way around. This particular bottle, I don't really care which way the cracks are going, so I'm going to do it this way. If I were to paint this up and down, the majority of my cracks are going to be up and down. if I paint it around, then they're gonna go more circular. And it doesn't matter if you get this on this decal. That's what you don't want, is just, you don't want stuff in the middle. And if you get stuff in the middle, that's all right. There's a little piece of label still left there. So, and then what I do is I stick my finger in the top to do the rest of the bottle. So we're gonna go around. You can see where it's a little bit thicker in spots, so just kind of even it out a little bit. I sometimes use the same paintbrush for the crackle and for the glue part and then the paint part. Today I'm not, because I don't want big strokes on it. I want smaller ones. So this is almost done. Make sure you get it on all of it. The bottoms almost always have to be touched up. So that's kind of how thick I get it. Just go all the way around and put some back up here where your finger may have taken some off. You can kind of see where there's thicker spots in there. And actually, the way this camera's set up, I can see better looking at my computer screen where the thick part is. That's what's nice about these Lazy Susans. You can just turn the Lazy Susan. So you want to make sure that there's enough around the outside of this. So just like I showed in the other crackle video, the next thing you do is you hit it with a hair dryer. So when you're looking at this, and you're going to see that it looks a little bit glossy. You want to keep the hairdryer on it long enough to where it looks like it's barely starting to dry. And that does not take very long. So I'm just going to keep turning it around. So I can see right here I kind of have a blob. I'm going to just smooth that out just a little bit. So what you want it to get is kind of the look of something more matte than it is shiny with the glue. I can tell right here I just need to touch it up, put just a little more on there. That's going to be fine. So that is about the length of time that I do that. Then I take my paint, put it right here. I'm going to get a drink of coffee. My throat's icky. And if you hear a bunch of noise, I have 5 kittens that are playing in here. Stir up your paint. This is the homemade chalk paint. So I start again at the top and I go around like this. Be careful, it's not too much, it takes practice. It's really easy, but to get it the way you want it, you just keep practicing. So you can see that I have most of it covered. And then I'm doing this really light, and I move backwards like this. And it doesn't matter how you do it, but I think this gets more consistent. See, and with this Lazy Susan, I'm just moving the Lazy Susan. I'm telling you, it is a great investment for crackle paint. Then I start down here and I go down maybe 3 inches and I keep going around again. And around again. Actually, it just really doesn't take very long. I did 20 of them yesterday. I'm getting ready to do a bazaar and hopefully open up a little holiday gift shop inside here, but my house, but I don't know. We'll have to see how that goes. So it's starting to crack a little bit on the top, and that's okay. I'm gonna go down. Now I'm painting right over that decal. So what's kind of cool, and I haven't done it yet, is like I'm gonna do some, probably do some star decals next. See, I'm going down about that far. You can see. I just keep doing small strokes back and forth. But I'm going to do some star decals and do the same method. I have a new method to show people who just aren't satisfied with this crackle. Oops, that could have been bad. This crackle method, it's actually using chalk paint that's been almost too, it's way too dry to do this with. And I kind of discovered it by accident, which is usually how I discover any of the stuff I do. And it turns out really pretty. I'll have to grab the bottle and show you. I'm gonna do two videos on this. It'll be one, or a part one and a part two. Now see, I've gone all the way down to the bottom because I'm gonna let this dry and then come back and show you how I put the decals and finish this up. This is your basic bottle, prepping your bottle. So if you're doing a bazaar or something, you can knock 10 of these out and then come back when they're dry and finish them up. And for bazaar stuff, people love anything lit up. If it lights up, if you make a wreath and you want it to sell, and you know there's other wreath people at your bazaar, put lights in them. And they will almost always pick the ones with the lights first. I make snowmen that are lit, now these wine bottles that are lit, I have ornaments that are lit up. It's kind of one of those surefire things. Now, on the bottom, I'm just going to take this. And as you can see, there it doesn't get it really well on the bottom. Okay, so that is finished as far as that goes. Now I'm going to take my hair dryer. It's going to take a little bit longer, but you're going to actually be able to see it crack. We'll do it this way. It should be this way. And just keep turning it around. You want to make sure that you hit around this oval pretty good. And this will not make it all the way dry. You need to set this overnight. If I'm in a hurry, sometimes I'll set them in, take the wraps out of the oven and set them in the oven on about 200 for half hour, 20 minutes. Hopefully you can see that it's starting to crack. And I get my hair dryer right up to it. As you can see, it's really cracked, and it's pretty even, and that does take some practice. But you will get it even. Okay, so that's about as much as I'm going to use a blow dryer on. Pick it up and bring it up to the camera. Oh, that doesn't work because I have crappy lighting. There you go. It's all cracked.